Good morning, students. We are going to continue with the poem which I was explaining you yesterday, right? What is name of our poem? The name of our poem. So, I would like to explain you poem again. First of all, I will recite poem and then I will explain you in short what is there in the poem, what poet is saying in the poem. Here, strawberries that in gardens grow are plump and juicy fine. Now here it is told that strawberries that grow, that in gardens grow, whichever strawberries grow in gardens, they are plump and juicy fine. They are plump means what? They are fat, they are big. I have written meaning of plump over here. Plump means what? Big or fat. They are juicy also means there is lot of juice in those strawberries. Correct? Here it is told that strawberries that in gardens grow, means strawberries which grows in garden, they are plump. They are plump means what? They are quite fat and big. Okay, their strawberries are quite big. And even they are juicy fine. Strawberries are what? Strawberries are juicy fine. I'm drawing picture of strawberry for you, students, so that our period will look colorful, correct or not? And if I am drawing strawberry and showing you picture of strawberry, it will make our today's period more interesting. So strawberries that in gardens grow, how are those strawberries which grows in garden? They are plump and juicy fine. Juicy fine means what? Yes, quite there is juicy in those strawberries. They are big, they are fat, they are reddish in color, but sweeter far as wise men know.
The strawberries that are grown on the vines in the woods are more sweeter than this. Correct or not? Wise man knows the strawberries which are grown in the garden, they are sweet. No problem. He is not having any problem. But then he is telling that the strawberries which grows on the vine, vine means what? Vine means a creeping plant that grows up or over thing. Now, creeping plant means what? Well, yesterday I told you, vine means what? Well, it is a creeping plant. Creeping plant means what? Well. Ani well kashavarti chadto? Well dusra jhadavarti chadto kiwa ekadya vastu varti chadto, right? So, vine means what? Well. So, here it is told that the strawberries which we get on the vine which grows in wood means what? In the forest, they are more sweeter than the strawberries which grows in the garden. And who is telling that? There is a wise man who knows that strawberries which grows in wood are more sweeter than the strawberries that grow in the garden. So that was our first two stanzas. Okay, strawberries that in gardens grow are plump and juicy fine, but sweeter far as wise men know, spring from the woodland vine. Spring from means what? What is meaning of spring from? Spring from means which arise from. Now, from where does this strawberry looks? Spring from means what? Arise from. Spring from meaning is what? Arise from. If a wise man will go in the forest, or if the wise man will go in the woods, he will see there is a vine. Vine means what? There is a creeper which is grown on the wood, and that creeper has what? Strawberries. And those strawberries are, he will say, "Are, huh? These strawberries are really very sweet, huh? Well, there is a garden near my house, for example. I am just telling. There is a garden near my house. In that garden also, there are strawberries, but those strawberries are sweet. No problem, they are sweet, they are juicy, they are plumpy. But the strawberries which I am eating in the woodland, these strawberries are more sweeter than the strawberries which grows in the garden." This is explanation of first four lines. I think you have understood. Now, next stanza is, no need for bowl or silver spoon, sugar or spice or cream. Now this wise man is telling that, or the poet is saying that we don't need any spoon. Spoon means what? Chamcha. Correct? We don't need cream. Correct? We don't need sugar. Sugar means what? Saakar. We don't need any spice. Spice means what? We make powder. We make powder from some plants. That is called spice. Spice means what? Masala. Then when we want to eat strawberry, which is there in woodland or which is grown in the garden, do we have to eat with those strawberry sugar? Strawberry barbar sugar khato ka apan? Garaj ahe ka? No. There is no need of sugar, there is no need of cream, there is no need of spice, there is no need of silver spoon. Silver spoon means what? Silver spoon means chandicha chamcha, right? So it is said that we don't need bowl, we don't need silver spoon, we don't need sugar, we don't need spice, or we don't need cream to eat that strawberry. Has the wild berry plucked in June? Now here a poet is saying that when we go and pluck strawberries in which month? In June, besides the trickling stream. Now this strawberry is grown where? Near the trickling stream. Trickling means what? Flowing slowly. Water, which is stream, means what? Water. The place where water is flowing, correct? When the place where water is flowing, there is a vine of strawberry, and that strawberry, when I am eating, they are more sweet than the strawberries which grow in the garden. And poet is saying that to eat that strawberry, I don't need any bowl, I don't need any silver spoon, I don't need sugar, I don't need cream, I don't need any spice to eat along with this strawberries. So this is the what explanation given in the poem. I think you have understood. Comparison is done. Comparison means what? There is done comparison between strawberries which are grown in two different places. Correct? There is a strawberry which is grown in garden, and there is a strawberry which is grown in the woodland. Woodland means what? In the woods, anywhere naturally which grows. Now they are saying that, strawberry which is grown in garden, it is also sweet, and the strawberry which is grown in woods, that is also sweet. But when we will do comparison between these two strawberries, which strawberry will be more sweeter? The strawberry which is grown in the woods is more sweeter than the strawberry which is grown in the garden. Have you understood the poem? I think you have understood. Now here are some questions. Some questions are given in your book. Read the poem and answer the following questions, okay? Now those questions I will take now. I will just revise it orally, okay? Here it is told, which are the two different places where strawberries grow? Where are the two different places where strawberries grow? Now strawberries can be grown in garden and also in the woods near streams. Do you want me to write down answers? I will write down answers which are small, that I will write down now. Okay, first answer. Strawberries grow in gardens. Strawberries grow in gardens and also in the woods near streams. This is first answer, okay? Please write down answers from the board. I know you people are not going to find out answers, and you are not going to write down answers on your own. So I have written answers on the board. Please see it and then write down, okay? Next one, second question which is asked here is, what are the two different ways of eating strawberries? First way is what? Strawberry can be eaten by using bowl, silver spoon, okay? You can write down that answer by adding sugar, by adding cream, or by adding spice. And second way is what? Strawberries can be eaten directly after plucking it from the plant or from the vine. Vine means what? Well. Third question which is asked here is, which strawberries are plump and juicy? I will write down answer of third question, okay? Which strawberries are plump and juicy? The strawberries grown in garden. The strawberries grown in the garden are plump and juicy. Okay, fourth question is, which strawberries are sweeter? Now you can, which strawberries are sweeter? The strawberries growing in the woods on vine are sweeter. Just a minute, I will rub board and write down fourth answer. Strawberries grown, strawberries growing in the woods, growing in the woods are more sweeter. Fifth question, which is asked over here, is in your book, is how would you like to eat your strawberries? Now this answer, fifth answer, you have to write down on your own, okay? Fifth answer you have to write. It is for you. It is your views. You have to write down fifth answer in your own words. Second answer, it is very easy. Strawberries can be eaten in bowl. Strawberries can be eaten with silver spoon or with sugar or spice or cream. And second way, strawberries can be directly eaten after plucking it from the tree or plucking it from the vine, not tree, from the vine. Have you understood all question answers? Okay, your homework is what? You have to write down. What is your homework? Answer the following questions. Whatever question answers are given in the book, in your book, downside of the poem, question answers are given, that question answers you have to complete. Answer the following questions. You have to write down questions and answers I have given. You can zoom my video and write down answers from the board. Okay, this is your today's homework. Have you understood poem? In this way, we have completed our fourth topic of fifth standard. We will start with new topic. Now most probably I am going to start with your grammar part. So tomorrow we will start with grammar first lesson. Okay, that's all for today. See you tomorrow.